On October 11th of 2022, the alert level was raised at the Grimsvotn Volcano in Iceland, increasing from green to yellow. This change was made due to the fact that a section of the volcano's ice cap began to rapidly subside on October 5th, and as of the writing of this video, has sunk by 4.3 meters or 14.1 feet. This subsidence indicates that a glacial flood is about to occur or is already underway, which is known as a Jökulhlaup. While the exact relationship between these Jökulhlaups and volcanic eruptions is still debated, it is widely accepted that on several occasions a Jökulhlaup preceded or coincided with a volcanic eruption. This occurred in 1922, 1938, 1954, and most recently in 2004. Although Jökulhlaups occur around the planet for varying reasons, when they originate from the Grimsvotn volcano, which is largely buried underneath a thick ice sheet, they almost certainly are volcanic in origin. Since Grimsvotn has a presumably large volume magma chamber as indicated by its ability to produce highly voluminous effusive and explosive eruptions, it also has a large geothermal system consisting of abundant fumaroles which are buried beneath the thick ice sheet. These fumaroles regularly release volcanic gases at above the boiling point of water, which melts sections of the overlying glaciers, creating a thick subglacial lake which can have on the order of several cubic kilometers of water. The rate of melting responds to the movement of magma at depth, meaning that it can increase or decrease. All of this water eventually floods at a path of least resistance, creating a Jökulhlaup that floods distant drainages of the volcano. You might hear all of this and think that the relationship between Jökulhlaups and volcanic eruptions couldn't be more self-explanatory, as it is true that fresh lava erupted onto the surface or beneath a thick ice sheet can generate a glacial flood. However, this doesn't describe the full picture, as shown by Grimsvotn producing a Jökulhlaup in 2004, 5 days before the eruption began. The reason this was believed to have occurred relates to the pressure exerted by the massive overlying water and glacial ice on the volcano's magma chamber. While meltwater is piling up beneath the thick ice sheet, the notable mass of this material makes it incredibly difficult for a volcanic eruption to occur. For an eruption to occur, the tensile stress on rock overlying the magma chamber needs to become positive. This can occur quite quickly with removal of a sufficient amount of overlying water and ice, causing dike propagation to begin and often leading to a volcanic eruption. Thus, although a volcanic eruption can trigger a Jökulhlaup can also trigger a volcanic eruption. However, most Jökulhlaups from the Grimsvotn volcano have not led to volcanic eruptions, although statistics seem to suggest that each event carries with it a very low double-digit percentage chance of causing a volcanic eruption or occurring alongside one. For example, since Grimsvotn's last eruption in 2011, it has produced 10 separate Jökulhlaups, not including the one which is ongoing. And Grimsvotn often produces volcanic eruptions which are completely unrelated to Jökulhlaups. With this being said, this large caldera complex volcano has been the most historically active in Iceland, at least since 1000 CE. During that time, it has produced 78 volcanic eruptions, although there is a potential undercounting of these events, as in the last 100 years, 18 eruptions have occurred. Grimsvotn's recent eruptions have been universally explosive to a degree, so if it was to erupt, it would likely affect regional air traffic. However, Grimsvotn's 2011 eruption, which was rated as a VEI-4, was unusually large, representing the volcano's largest in 138 years. Most of Grimsvotn's eruptions are two orders of magnitude smaller, rating in as a VEI-2. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my patron, Dr. Stu, for increasing their pledge on this channel's Patreon page.